tents where it's anything but sunny. A few hours of devastating rain, and the whole southeast is hit by Britain's worst floods for 15 years. The Medway is only one river to burst its banks. Hundreds of roads disappear. Hundreds of bridges threaten to give way before the torrent. Hundreds of boats are torn from their moorings. And as for crops already battered by a bad summer, nobody yet knows how many thousands of acres are completely lost. Train services are paralyzed, and over wide areas, road traffic is impossible too. For many of the children, the whole thing's an adventure. And perhaps it's just as well it keeps them happy, because so many families are homeless until the floods go down, and maybe still after that. One of the worst hit towns is Tunbridge. The high street is a river, a yard deep. More than 300 people have to leave their homes, and the townspeople are warned to boil their water because of the danger of contamination. Shopkeepers rescue what goods they can. Many of their windows have been smashed in by the pressure of the rising water. And there may be more to come. The AA warns that almost every brook, stream, and river in the southeast is at danger level. Already, local authorities and members of parliament are asking, how could it all happen without warning? Why did neither the long range nor the immediate weather forecasts hint at the disaster to come? And they'll be wanting an answer.